so you might be wondering, what is this video? It's some events I have added to the Cold War the Iron Curtain mod to make the Korean War happen. So let me show you some of the events. I think there's around 20 of them. To start the war, include the US and China, as well as on armistice once the war has gone on for long enough and there's no winner. Also for scenarios where either the North or the South conquer the other. So yeah, let's start the clock and speed up the game. Then you get to see what happens. The pause right there. War in Korea. Communist forces of the Democratic People's Republic of Korea have launched a surprise attack against the pro-capitalist Republic of Korea. Who will end up the victor in this struggle remains to be seen. We better get the US to help us. And the event buttons in these events depends on what nation or government type you're playing as. So this is we better get the US to help us is specific if you're playing as South Korea, while as if you're playing North Korea or China, it will instead say everything is going according to plan. And we continue and you will see what happens. I'm not gonna try to play right now, just to show off the events for you. I will be releasing this, in case you were wondering. The US enters the Korean conflict. They're not involved from the start, but a week or two or three in, they enter the war. And they get an event where they can choose to participate or just ignore the conflict and stay out of it. But as the AI, they will always accept and enter the Korean War. So we have the US has entered the Korean conflict on the side of the Republic of Korea against the Communist Democratic People's Republic of Korea. Good, we really need it. So, yeah, it's called the Korean War, but that's not my fault, that's the game. So we can see it's North Korea against Korea, the US, and every single, well, there's a few of them, but they will call in literally every NATO ally. Which is kind of what happened with the United Nations and so on. But I have made precautions to keep North Korea from calling in the Soviets and everyone in the Eastern Bloc, because, well, I don't want it to become a world war just like that. So there have been measures to prevent that. And if we cheat a bit, here you can see that China also enters the conflict. Communist China has entered the Korean conflict on the side of the Democratic People's Republic of Korea against the Capitalist Republic of Korea. Please no. Yeah, because the North Koreans were obviously not enough. So, yeah, they won't join right away. Either there are two ways. China also get a choice, and they always accepts for them. But there's two ways for the Chinese to join the war. Either you advance as the South Koreans, or whoever. Just that North Korea needs to lose Pyongyang and the surrounding area. Or perhaps just the city itself. When they do that, the Chinese will immediately intervene, or else after as historical at the end of October in 1950 they will otherwise intervene on their own. So yeah, this is what happens. And then if the war keeps going for 3 years, the armistice will be called, which, depending on if China or the US is involved in the war, they will propose an armistice, or if neither of them are, the United Nations will do it on its own. And then there is victory events in case one of them capture the other, and they will annex it, and there will be peace once I fix those events. So yeah, this mod really needed flavor and some conflicts that happen, because I think the timelapse I made of the mod, barely anything happened over 30 or so years. Yeah, thanks for watching.